My name is Clara Ward, and I was the lead singer for the successful gospel group, the Ward Singers. I was born Clara Mae Ward on April 21st, 1924, to Gertrude Ward, as the youngest of two daughters in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. When I was just 7 years old, my older sister, Willareen, or Willa as we called her, and I began performing with our mother in Philadelphia. We were originally called the Consecrated Gospel Singers before becoming the Ward Trio. We mostly sang around the city in different churches, making appearances as we could before becoming an overnight sensation after performing at the National Baptist Convention in Chicago in 1943. From there, we began to tour across the nation. In 1949, we added new members Henrietta Waddy and Marion Williams. Together, we traveled to Los Angeles to record our first songs for the Milltone label. By 1950, we had become the hottest female singing group with hit gospel songs such as Surely God Is Able and Move Up a Little Higher. Under the Gotham label, we were promoted as the famous Ward Singers, and this name stuck until years later we renamed ourselves Clara Ward and the Ward Singers. During this time, I had become the lead singer of our group and lead musical director. We accomplished many things as a group throughout the 1930s to the 1950s. My mother created a booking agency for gospel acts, sponsored tours under the name the Ward Gospel Cavalcade, established a publishing house for gospel music, and wrote instruction manuals for churches to follow during their gospel programs. I was also honored when Mahalia Jackson decided to cover How I Got Over. How I Got Over allowed me to add my distinctive sound and arrangement to traditional hymn and continued with Miss Jackson, who made it her signature song during her performances. Though I was the musical director, I was always willing to share the spotlight with other talented artists. Likewise, my mother and I also shared the group's financial rewards with the other members who were grossly underpaid, including my sister Willa. It was much more rewarding to share and to celebrate together than apart. I understood that we all played important roles in the success of our group. Unfortunately, it would not be enough. Marion would leave in 1958 when her request for higher pay would be rejected by the label. Soon after, the others remaining members of the group would follow her departure. Though their loss was great, my mother had no trouble finding new members to add to the Ward Singers. As they say, the show must go on, and so we did. Our new act drew in a larger white audience and we became more mainstream. The new direction caused us to lose much of our African-American church-going supporters, but we gained in overall exposure and recognition. New songs like Down by the Riverside and When the Saints Go Marching became mainstream hits, and we performed these on major television networks, at nightclubs, and at Disneyland. We even toured nearly 2 months with comedian Jack Benny. Since my death in 1973, I was honored at the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 1977, with my sister Willa accepting the award on my behalf. In 1998, the United States Postal Office recognized my status and issued a 32-cent stamp with my image. As I have stated before, I started singing at a very young age. I joined my mother in a singing group when I was just 7 years old. The gift of song was very dear to me. You could best believe, even in death, I am singing now.